Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Victor Huerta here, local real estate agent and investor in Arizona, giving you the Phoenix housing market update. While I sit at this open house, this beautiful house behind me, I'll actually give you a video tour of this house here located in Ocotillo, Chandler, right across Intel Corporation in this video as well. But I wanted to break down the housing market. I've been getting a lot of questions. Hey, has the housing market slowed down? Well, we're going to get into that right away.
This is where they go for the real estate info. I'm here to lead and help you succeed.
One thing that you'll learn about me is I'm on a mission to give the knowledge to the world when making decisions in buying and selling real estate.
Victor Huerta.
Remember my name.
Today we're going to get into the housing market for October, because you know that's the info that you want to hear as I sit here on this beautiful property here in Chandler, right across Intel in Ocotillo, Echelon in Ocotillo. I wanted to give you the actually Phoenix housing market for October of 2021, because you know you need this data when you're thinking about buying, selling, or investing in some real estate here in Arizona. And you know that I leverage a lot of smart people in this real estate market. And so I have the data on my iPad from the Cromford Report, and I pay for this out of my own pocket. And I'm gonna give it to you for free. Give it to you for free because that's what you want. So anyways, let's deep dive into this housing market, because you know, you guys gotta know what's going on with this market in 2021. Going into the holidays. If you think you should buy, sell, or invest in real estate, all my information is below. And don't forget to click the subscribe button and that bell to get notified once we drop the latest video, my friends. And here we go. Are you ready? Because I'm ready. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so let's get right into the data. I got my iPad here. I want to give you all the information, okay, so you can actually think about buying, selling, or investing in some real estate here in Arizona. So what we're going to get into is October 6th of 2021, and we're going to compare it to October 6th of 2020. So right now we have active listings for sale, 7,577. That is a minus 11.5%, my friends. Listings under contract, 11,910. That is also down 11.7%. The monthly median sales price is up 23.9%. As you know, prices keep on going up, up, and up. And I'm gonna explain what's happening here at my open house, where the clients are coming from, migration, what cities are they coming from. So it's very, very interesting what's happening here in Arizona. The monthly median sales price, $408,790. That price has gone up, and it just continues to rise. I just don't know if the train's gonna stop here. Especially what's happening in this open house with the migration coming in from different states. I got some great info, so you don't wanna leave, okay? Because this is top-notch information that you're gonna receive. So closed sales, 8,971. We are down 0%. 0%, it's the same. Listing success rate, October 2021. That's 89.5%. You have an 89.5% selling your house in this market. The market is still on fire. Still on fire right now. Still hot. Months of supply. Very important. 0.8 months. In October of 2019, we had 1.7 months. October 2020, we had 1 month. And now we're at 0.8 months. Meaning it's a hot seller's market still. Heading into the holidays, I do not see it slowing down. Do you? Leave a comment below. Let me know what are your thoughts of all this information. But let's get into some real good information on the selling side for you sellers thinking about selling and then buying another house. All right, ladies and gentlemen. So let's get into the selling side if you're thinking about selling your house in this area and thinking about buying another house. Now, the greater Phoenix housing market is cooling, but far from cold, my friends. That is right. Far from cold. The last 6 months, let's put this in perspective. April 1st to October 1st, supply rose 92%. from 3,591 homes all the way up to 6,833 active listings for sale. But in the same time frame, listings under contract dropped 9% to 11,939. And while we had a rise in supply and a decline in contracts and escrow, indicated that the market was cooling off. Wrong. We're totally wrong, right? So despite all of this happening, okay, we still have an inventory shortage. A massive inventory shortage. It is crazy over here. And if you are a seller and still thinking that you're not gonna be able to sell your house, that is a false narrative story that you're putting in your head. If you're thinking you can't buy a house, that is a false, maybe true story that you're putting in your head. I'm just gonna be honest, it's kind of difficult, but you gotta have a game plan when you're thinking about selling your house and buying another house, especially in the state of Arizona. So let me explain something to you. I am here at this beautiful open house. Okay, let me explain to you. This beautiful house that you see behind me, okay, this is a beautiful home. In Ocotillo, in Chandler, 4 beds, 3 baths, Echelon and Ocotillo. This is the downstairs. I'm just gonna give you the tour downstairs. The migration is serious, folks. Let me explain something to you. Migration is serious. All the buyers walking into this open house, Portland, Oregon, Los Angeles, Chicago, New York City, all of them, they all have leases over here. They've all leased a property because they left those states. So that's who your competition is if you're local. Okay, the migration is crazy here for home buyers. So if you're a seller, you have all these people coming in to buy properties in Arizona. So why would you want to sell it to those iBuyers? We're sitting right now at this beautiful property, and I've had 22 people come in, and almost all of them from out of state. Some are local, but mostly from the states. I just actually explained the situation to you. So if you think you can't sell your house for top dollar, you are wrong, my friends. You are wrong. You just have to have a game plan to sell your house and go buy a house. Okay? So sellers, be aware of what's happening in this market. Okay? Truthful from the heart. All the clients are coming from out of state. Okay? And all those states. Okay? All of them. I'm sitting here right across Intel. This house is listed for $799. Okay? We've been on the market 10 days. It's gonna get sold to the right buyer, but it's a beautiful house. Okay, right across Intel, Echelon, and Ocotillo. So sellers, if your property looks as good as this, okay, behind me, right? You're gonna sell, okay, $799. That's where we're at. We're at the luxury market right now, $799. So just keep that in mind. And it doesn't matter what price point, I help out all clients in different price points, but this is what $799 looks like. And I'll link up the video right here. But sellers, if you're trying to make the move, you still can make the move during the holidays, coming into the holidays as well. So I just want to share that information with you on where the migration is coming from. So if you're a seller, there you are. Let's roll into the buying side. All right, my friends, if you are on the buying side, I am bringing you upstairs to another level, to another level. But anyways, hey, if you're looking to buy a house, let me explain something to you. There's a lot of competition. Okay, crazy competition right now if you're on the buying side trying to buy a house. Let me explain something to you, okay? Let me put this down and explain something to you real quick, okay? Oh, let me adjust this. Hold on. Right. Yeah. Okay, buyers. I have a couple clients, okay? Looking in the 350 range, 400,000 range in the West Valley. Talking about Glendale, Levine, Avondale, North Phoenix. We can't get an offer accepted. Not if you're using FHA loans. I mean, we put in a couple contracts. We have been denied. We're getting outbidded. Outbidded by cash buyers, conventional buyers, VA buyers. So if you're gonna buy something and you're using FHA financing, we're gonna have to increase the price a little bit. You're gonna have a little bit of cushion of money to go over asking price, and we're still waiving inspections, we're still waiving appraisals, earnest money hard. We're trying to make it as strong as possible, but right now I'm having a difficult time with my first-time home buyers. Luxury market, if you're at 500,000 and above, it's a little easier. It's a little easier. And the reason why I say that is because you're using conventional financing. When you have conventional financing, you actually are a little bit more stronger buyer, okay? And you can get a property accepted. Oh, look at that shower. It's beautiful, isn't it? Beautiful shower. Anyways, so with that being said, if you're buying at 400,000 and below, you're gonna have to be patient with me. You're gonna have to be patient. It's gonna take the right property and the right offer. And we still gotta move fast. Still have to move fast, my friends, on this one. But, oh, look at that, beautiful shower. Beautiful shower. But my friends, buying a house, it is a little difficult. I am not gonna lie to you because you know I like to bring the truth. Okay, but it can be done. We just gotta move a little faster. Okay, like Speedy Gonzalez. Arriba, arriba, arriba. Okay, and we're just gonna have to do that. We're just gonna have to move a little faster if you're in the $400,000 price range and below. You know, 500, 550, we got a chance to get you in something real, real quick. But we're just gonna have to take a little bit more time as a first-time home buyer. All right, sorry, my friends. Somebody came into the open house right now. And just the looky-loos neighbors, you know. Just, you get those in the open houses. It's okay, it's okay. But anyways, where was that? Oh, yes. If you are a home buyer looking under, let me see. Man, you know, 425 is pretty tough. I think somebody came in, hold on. Okay, so 425 is pretty tough, but once you get into like the 500, it's luxury. This property right here, like I said, is $799. It's a typical different buyer, right? It's a different buyer in this buyer pool and when you have a listing like this. But I'm still helping out clients, right? Try to get them in the house at 350, 400,000 below, and it's tough out there. You have a lot of people migrating for this listing, and it is everywhere, right? You still have the investors buying cash. And a couple things to structure your offer if you're a first-time home buyer or a repeated home buyer is you're still going to have to waive appraisal, okay? They want that appraisal waiver. If you're not willing to waive appraisals, you're probably not going to get a house, okay? Inspection period. I'm seeing some contracts that I'm writing where we're getting inspections, we're able to do inspections, but we're having to waive some stuff, okay? Your seller's not going to repair anything. And plus, Arizona contract is written where they don't have to do it. So you could do a home inspection for peace of mind only and not ask for repairs, but we're pretty much waiving inspections as well. We're not asking for home warranties at all. So we're not asking for home warranty as well. And then also, what else are we doing? Earnest money hard, right? We're putting some money hard. So meaning that when you write your contract, you have to deposit earnest money, which you're saying, hey, handshake to the seller. I'm really serious about buying your house, but this is how serious I am. I'm gonna put $2,500 goes hard at contract acceptance, meaning when you as a seller sign on the dotted line, if I back out, you just earn $2,500. So when you're dealing with a property and looking at a property like this, you have to make sure you truly, truly like the property or love it in order to do this, okay? I don't advise all my clients to do this. I explain it and I said, hey, this is a tactic to try to make your offer a little bit more stronger to get accepted. You don't have to do it. It's just my opinion, right? Giving you some feedback, coaching you, strategizing, because I know you really want the house. But the migration is real, folks. People are leaving, okay? Okay. And it has to deal with, how can I say this without getting flagged? How can I say this without getting flagged? You know what I'm talking about. Not only that, okay, but the GOVNERMENT all over the place, right across all 50 states, a lot of people are just leaving, okay? We have people from Portland, Oregon, like I said, Chicago, New York City, LA. People are just migrating here, right? And they're coming down here and they're just grabbing a lease for a year and then starting looking for a house. So sellers have the leverage on you home buyers, Okay, it's just plain and simple. And you just have to do the math whether you want to rent and hope that the market corrects a little bit, but your rent payment is almost the same or even more as a mortgage payment. So why would you want to keep on paying rent when you can own a house? You know, I put myself on blast. I always do. I might regret this, but I don't see this ship slowing down at all. At all. And it's crazy. It's like, we're shopping for a vehicle, right? Okay. Tranny blew on my last video. If you didn't watch that one, kind of went into that. So transmission blew in the vehicle. That car is done. We're looking for a new vehicle. And they got us by the, you know what, right? They're charging a markup over MSRP on all kinds of cars, all kinds of vehicles, okay? They got me by the, you know what. The sellers got you guys by the, you know what. Actually, you know what? I wouldn't say I'm a buyer's agent. I'm almost in the realm of sellers and buyers right now, okay? I've been in the business for a long time where I'm actually getting a lot of listings now and helping buyers, meaning helping them sell and buy another house, helping them sell their old house, go into new construction, sell and upgrade to a different price point, you know, all that stuff. So it's you have to have the right agent, mentor, leader, and coach to kind of guide you to see on the other side, right? You need to be able to see to the other side. And when you have an experienced agent who can do that and be like, hey, this is what I'm seeing. These are the hot areas. I think you should do this. You know, just giving you some feedback, maybe do this, maybe do that, choose an option. And then we go from there. But it's not only happening in Arizona, right? It's happening in other states as well. But the migration is real. If you're a home buyer, you have a lot of competition. But you just got to stick it out. You just have to put your boxing gloves on and duke it out. Because no matter what, when you're renting, you're paying somebody's mortgage. It's just not yours. And that's the difference. You always want it to be yours. So, with that being said, my friends, I am almost done with this open house, this beautiful home. 4 beds, 3 baths, almost 3,000 square feet, 6,000 square foot lot. And priced at $799. A lot of people are saying, like, hey, I can't believe it's not sold yet. I had an agent come in here. They're thinking about putting their property for sale. It's right down the street, actually, in the same neighborhood. And they're like, oh, we don't want to come to the market yet because we're waiting for you to get under contract. What's going on? And I said, I don't know. You tell me. It's a hot market. We're right across Intel, man. It's right across Intel. 5262 coming in, and it hasn't sold you. We're not under contract. Am I scared? No. It's just going to take some time. We're in the luxury market. When you're in the luxury market, it takes a little bit more time to sell a property. But you pretty much got all the tour, and you got the housing market update, okay? So I hope you enjoyed today's video. Once again, Victor Huerta, your local real estate agent and investor as well. When you hire me and my wife, you get the best of both worlds. The investment mindset, the real estate mindset, the agent mindset, buying your first home, selling your first home to do the 2-for-1, sell, buy your primary, get an investment property. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed today's market update, or this month's market update. I shouldn't say today's because I'm at the open house for today, but I hope you enjoyed it. I always love talking to my peeps on the YouTube. I love you guys. Hey, do me a favor. Click the subscribe button. Come on, click that like button and the bell to get notified once I drop the latest video, because I'm bringing nothing but the fire when you think about buying, selling, or investing in some real estate. And we will see you on the other side. And yes, when you meet me, I am this crazy. Okay? So all the people who have helped on YouTube, leave me a comment. Yes, you guys, leave me a comment. Just put Victor's the best guy.
If you have any questions, email me at victor@freeagentproperties.com. Again, that email address is victor@freeagentproperties.com, where we release new videos each week on home buyer tips, home seller tips, the Phoenix housing market updates, so you can be mindful when you're thinking about buying, selling, or investing in real estate. We will talk to you soon.